The Duchess of Sussex dazzled in diamonds and bespoke designer gowns when she visited Australia, New Zealand, Tonga and Fiji with husband Prince Harry last autumn. But Meghan, 38, took a decidedly more low-key approach for her public engagements in Cape Town and Johannesburg on their most recent tour, which came to an end today. Indeed, the royal spent just over £4,100 on new wardrobe items for the 10-day visit. While it is an eye-watering amount for any normal person, it is just a fraction of the estimated £118,000 she spent on outfits for her last royal tour, and decidedly modest for a royal by any standard. Part of this is due to the fact that Prince Harry, 35, and Meghan decided not to include any formal evening engagements in their schedule, thus rendering any expensive black tie attire unnecessary. A single Oscar de la Renta gown worn on the last royal tour cost an estimated £10,000, others came in at roughly £1,000. The other driving force is understood to be the Sussexes' wish for this royal tour to be more low-key than their last, with Meghan understood to have deliberately chosen more casual looks in the hope the focus would remain on the causes highlighted by their carefully chosen engagements. The other driving force is understood to be the Sussexes' wish for this royal tour to be more low-key than their last, with Meghan understood to have deliberately chosen more casual looks in the hope the focus would remain on the causes highlighted by their carefully chosen engagements. Speaking to For Mail previously, etiquette expert William Hansen said, "It is understandable that their royal highnesses want the press attention to focus on the issues and causes that they are there to champion rather than the more superficial aspects of royal life, as often happens on royal tours. There is also a larger amount of poverty in South Africa, and so to arrive wearing expensive designers and high fashion may be somewhat jarring." The Duchess sent this message loud and clear on the first day of the tour when she arrived at a Cape Town township in a £69 wrap dressed by a Malawian designer and a pair of simple wedges she had worn previously. Notably absent was her glittering engagement ring, thought to be worth as much as £140,000, which was replaced by a far more discreet £200 turquoise band by celebrity jeweler Jennifer Meyer. Meghan also relied heavily on outfits she has worn on previous royal engagements. Roughly half of the pieces worn on the tour had already been seen. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry are currently taking part in their first royal tour since the birth of their first child, baby Archie. Ahead of the Africa tour, Meghan left her engagement ring at home to avoid making people feel uncomfortable, claimed Nine News Australia presenter Tom Steinfurt. He said, "It's finally working well for Prince Harry and Meghan because they're getting rave reviews for their tour of Africa with adorable Archie in tow as well." It's been reported that the Duchess of Sussex is really going out of her way to be seen hugging mums and kids, wearing old recycled clothes. Even leaving, and this is interesting this part, left her $200,000 engagement ring at home to avoid making people feel uncomfortable. Nine News guest Aaron commented, "I'm not going to weigh in, I think I'll give them the benefit of the doubt, I think both of them were very passionate about these kind of causes." Prior to getting together and Meghan prior to becoming a royal was very passionate about advocating for equality with women and a lot of other things. "I think they'll get smashed regardless, this is what I've learned over the last 10 years, so good on them for doing something for them and I'll leave it at that." Mr. Steinfurt asked a second guest, "Tommy, what would you make if your missus took her engagement ring off?" They jokingly replied, "I wouldn't blame her, but I think Aaron's got a great point, I think they're damned if they do, they're damned if they don't. But let's give them a bit of a fair crack at it and let them just try and be the people that they are." While Harry and Meghan initially undertook a number of royal engagements together, the duo later split up to focus on causes important to them as individuals. As Prince Harry spent time in Angola in a tribute to his late mother's work with landmines, the Duchess of Sussex took the time to hold some secret meetings of her own. Meghan Markle spent last week in South Africa, where she made several visits to significant locations and organizations. One of Meghan's visits was revealed after the fact to be the post office where student Uyinna Mrwana was murdered earlier this year. According to a post on the Duchess of Sussex's Instagram account, she visited to pay her respects and to show solidarity with those who have taken a stand against gender-based violence and femicide. The same post later revealed Meghan had also taken part in a number of private visits over the weekend. The Instagram post said, "The Duchess has taken private visits and meetings over the last 2 days to deepen her understanding of the current situation and continue to advocate for the rights of women and girls. One of these private meetings was a breakfast held by the Duchess for women who have campaigned for equality in South Africa. Meghan held a meeting to find out about influential women's roles in their local and national community. Among attendees was Sophia Williams-de-Bruin, who led a march of 20,000 women against South Africa's apartheid laws in 1956. The Duchess made a speech at the breakfast in which she praised the brave women who led the way for generations of progress. She said, "I was recently reminded that the first one up the mountain often gets knocked down the hardest, but makes way for everyone behind them. These brave women have been able to see how their struggle can pave the way for so many. For all young women organizers, activists and campaigners today, you must keep at it and know that you are working for this generation and the next, and also continuing the legacy of the generations of great women before you." Meghan's next scheduled visit is tomorrow, where she will attend a countable event with the Association of Commonwealth Universities in Johannesburg. Meghan Markle will then reunite with Harry for their final day in Africa.